Caitlin Bristow is known for being honest and candid about her struggles, but there's a lot more to her story that explains how this former bachelorette became the woman she is today. So keep watching to discover her stunning transformation and journey to becoming a reality TV sweetheart. Bristow has been entertaining people ever since she was a toddler. A self-described drama queen, she divulged some details about her past on her YouTube channel, 9 to Wine with Caitlin Bristow. One of her earliest memories as a kid involved pulling down her pants anytime she got mad. She eventually discovered that these temper tantrums would elicit laughs, so whenever she got in trouble, she'd use the same strategy, although nowadays she doesn't use it so much anymore for obvious reasons.
I think from a young age, I loved the idea of entertaining, making people laugh.
Pants pulling wasn't Bristow's only talent back in the day. She also had a gift for music, as she would often sing Grace whenever her family was gathered around the dinner table. The Bristow clan wasn't even that religious, but a prayer before meals offered an opportunity to sing that young Caitlin couldn't pass up. And as she got older, she went on to perform in school productions of Bye Bye Birdie, West Side Story, and Fiddler on the Roof. Bristow grew up in the small Canadian town of Leduc, but she had big dreams of becoming a dancer. She knew from a young age that she wouldn't be able to achieve her goals if she remained in Alberta, so when she turned 18, she started auditioning for everything related to dance. She was well-versed in such styles as ballet, jazz, and even hip-hop. She eventually earned a scholarship that gave her the opportunity to dance with a company in Vancouver. At the time, that seemed like big city living for a small-town girl like her. As she recalled on her YouTube channel, "I remember I didn't have an apartment, I didn't have friends, I didn't have anything except for this hockey bag of clothes and the support from my family." Bristow lived the quintessential dancer's life, sharing space with roommates, not making much money, and surviving off of ramen, while also working at a restaurant to supplement her income. Ultimately, her devoted work ethic early would pay off. You can't keep Caitlin Bristow down. It's easy to become discouraged in a world where rejections are the norm, but she's learned to take everything in stride. On her YouTube channel, she's talked about how she managed to stay motivated while pursuing a dancing career despite countless rejections. She didn't let them affect her all that much, or at least she tried not to.
"As long as I knew that my heart was in the right place, I just kept going."
And keep going she did. When Bristow was in her 20s, she landed a gig as a cheerleader for a Canadian Football League team. At that point, she thought that she had peaked, and that things could only go downhill from there. But little did she know just how false that idea would turn out, as the same drive and determination that she used in her dancing career would eventually take her even further in life and in love. Caitlin Bristow is and always will be a hopeless romantic. She did, after all, star on a reality TV dating show not once, but twice. Prior to TV fame, she moved to Germany for a hockey player while putting her own cheerleading career on hold. Looking back, she realizes that she was a hopeless romantic who would do pretty much anything for love. When it comes to the topic of love, Bristow has always been a fighter. No matter how many times she's broken hearts or had her own heart broken, she's still clung to her belief in love. But her journey hasn't always been as glamorous as the one-on-one dates on The Bachelorette. When she was dating the hockey player in Germany, she realized she wasn't happy. Deep down, she knew that something was wrong when she put her life on hold for somebody else's.
"I was losing a little part of myself along the way."
Bristow felt lonely most of the time that she was in Germany, especially when her boyfriend was away for work. When that relationship ended and she returned home to Canada, she fell into a depression as she developed an addiction to Valium and her weight fell to just 93 pounds. Bristow eventually found a new calling and started working her way up in the restaurant industry with a new goal of becoming a general manager, but then another chance at finding love came knocking. With her best friend's encouragement, she decided to audition for The Bachelor. She ultimately appeared as a contestant on the 19th season in 2015, with Chris Soules serving as The Bachelor. Bristow ended up finishing in the top three after developing real feelings for Soules, but alas, she was let go in an emotional rose ceremony in Bali. Not long after her last episode aired, she told Good Morning America that she was completely shocked and blindsided by Soules' rejection. But 5 years later, she had a sense of humor about the whole experience, as she confessed on her YouTube channel in 2020. "Chris probably realized I was never going to make it on a farm in Iowa, even though I think I believed I could." Bristow may have had her heart broken by Chris Soules, but that didn't scare her away from trying her hand at love again, as she was cast as the lead attraction on The Bachelorette. Her season was full of drama and romance, and it ultimately ended with her accepting a proposal from personal trainer Sean Booth. The couple were engaged for 3 years, with Bristow even moving to Nashville, where Booth was from. But in 2018, they decided to end their engagement. In a statement released to People magazine, they admitted, "Even though we are parting as a couple, we are very much committed to remaining friends, and we will continue continue to support each other. Bristow was in love with Booth, but she also had to make sure that she stayed true to herself. Looking back now, she's able to poke fun at her younger self, as she's realized that there's a pattern when it comes to her relationships, though she's learned from each one and persevered. Bristow has had her heart broken, just like pretty much everyone else on this planet. But unlike most everyone else, she had to process the end of multiple relationships while millions of fans watched, which only added more pressure to the situation. After being rejected on The Bachelor, she gave love a second chance on The Bachelorette, only to have the engagement that came from that end after a few years. Clearly, Bristow's experienced a lot of emotional highs and lows on national TV, and unfortunately, being so public has left her vulnerable to criticism. During her time as The Bachelorette, she received tons of backlash for her openness about being intimate with one of the contestants prior to the infamous fantasy suite. As far as she sees it, there's a double standard at play here. As she told People magazine in 2015, "To me, it wasn't some crazy negative thing I was doing. If somebody was friends with somebody and they knew that they had sex in a relationship, they wouldn't go on social media and start slut-shaming them." Despite the criticism that Bristow faced, the experience ultimately made her a stronger person. Bristow is most famous as a reality TV star, but there's much more to this gal than made-for-TV drama. After she broke up with Sean Booth, she decided to stay in Nashville, as she had fallen in love with the city and its people. And since she already had a passion for music, her new home proved to be exactly her kind of place. After all, it is known as Music City. In May 2020, Bristow worked up the courage to release a single called If I'm Being Honest, a sort of ode to everything that she's learned and accepted about herself over the years. She announced the news on Instagram with a photo of the single cover, along with a caption in which she shared that she was a bit nervous about sharing her song with the world. As she wrote, "Singing has always been something that makes my heart happy, so if I'm being honest, I'm still feeling insecure, yet proud to share this with you now." Bristow eventually met the love of her life, but only after she started loving herself first. While she was visiting a friend in Seattle, she met Jason Tardik, who Bachelorette fans know from his time as a contestant on Becca Kufrin's season. She was in Seattle to look for local Bachelor Nation couples and contestants to appear on her podcast, Off the Vine with Caitlin Bristow. Out of all the options she had to pick from, she chose Tardik, who had just recently been rejected by Kufrin. Tardik joined Bristow on her YouTube channel and admitted that he was especially nervous about the podcast interview, as he just found out he lost the next Bachelor role to Colton Underwood. Bristow described the hug that Tardik gave her when they first met as electric, but Tardik admitted, "I don't think we realized what it was in that moment." However, upon leaving the interview, Tardik called up his buddies and told them that he just met his future wife. Can it get any more romantic than that?
You just can't talk yourself out of someone that makes you feel happy and who brings joy into your life. Like, why would you fight that?
Caitlin Bristow is a self-made woman, which she proved when she leveraged her reality TV fame to make money. Following her run as The Bachelorette, she went on to host her own podcast, which, according to Entrepreneur magazine, garners 1 million downloads per episode on average. She also has her own wine line called Spade and Sparrows, which launched in 2019. And on top of that, in 2020, she started her own YouTube show called 9 to Wine, which as of 2021 has more than 27,000 subscribers. And that's not all Bristow's been up to. In June 2018, she launched a hair accessory line called Do Edit, which features both scrunchies and headbands. Despite her reality TV popularity, she didn't realize just how much success she could have in her post-Bachelorette days, or how big a role social media would play in that success. As she told Entrepreneur magazine in 2019, "I didn't know what kind of platform I was going to have, or that I could turn it into a business or multiple businesses. I didn't understand the power of social media, so I just used it to show people a more behind-the-scenes approach at my life." She added, "I enjoyed that, and then I saw that money could come in, and then I also saw that I could build something more important here rather than just one-off making money, ride the wave kind of things." In June 2020, it was announced that Bristow would be appearing on the next season of Dancing with the Stars, something she'd long dreamed of doing. She received the happy news from Bachelor host Chris Harrison on an episode of The Bachelor, The Greatest Seasons Ever, making it a true full-circle moment. In an interview with Entertainment Tonight, she talked about how excited she was to put her dancing shoes back on, as she admitted, "I just think it goes to show if you really are into it and you are strong with what you believe in and fight for what you want, and as long as you are a good person doing those things, even if it takes 5 years, something good will come from it." Bristow was paired with professional partner Artem Chigvintsev, and she proved to be one of the strongest contestants. She was so strong, in fact, that she ended up winning the Mirror Ball Trophy as the champion of the season. After her big win, she wrote on Instagram, "My dream came true, and all of you were a part of it." Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more List videos about your favorite stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.